That was so much fun, right? Okay, so now we're going to build a snowman with some sensory snow. So it's really simple. You only need a few ingredients. You need cornstarch and shaving cream. And then optionally, you can have some glitter. Just makes it look pretty. But it can be very messy, so it's optional. And then you're going to want something to make it in. So I have this aluminum tin that I'm going to use. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to open our cornstarch. Cornstarch is a little messy, so we do it very carefully. I'm using one box. You can use two. Depends on how much snow you want to make. There we go. Pour it in. We go. I think cornstarch is messier than flour. So I've got my cornstarch. See? Now it might look like snow, but it's got a very soft consistency. So we want to give it a better consistency so we can build our snowman. So now we're going to add our shaving cream. You can add, the best way to do it is do a little bit at a time. So don't add the whole bottle at once. So there we go. That's good. This is going to get messy, by the way. And you're going to use your hands to mix it through. Kind of get in there. See? Messy, messy. But it's going to start to change consistencies. Now, you can add more shaving cream. I am making a mess. Okay. Could do this activity outside. That way, anything that falls out of the tin, goes on the concrete or the grass. But brilliant me and doing it right in front of my computer. So it's getting there, it's getting there. But I want to mix all the shaving creams through. Chunk of shaving cream in there. I'm gonna add a little bit more shaving cream. The fact that it's starting to stick to my hands a lot means that the consistency is getting better to mold into our snowman. Add some more. Mix it, mix it, mix it. Now, this recipe is not edible because shaving cream doesn't taste good. But there are recipes for edible sensories. sensory smell. You can Google those. You can even make your sensory smell different color by adding some Kool-Aid packets. It also gives it like a nice smell. Oh, it's good. This is good. Gonna add some more shaving cream. I think this is the last time I'm gonna add shaving cream. There we go. Make sure you get it between your fingers. Scoop up the shaving cream. If you see some dry bits of cornstarch, you know. This is also a really good workout for your arms. Okay, I kind of like the way this is. You know, it's up to you if you want to add more shaving cream or more cornstarch. It depends how you like the feel of it. There we go. Okay, I like this one. It's a little sticky. Strike that, it's a lot sticky. And now I'm going to add, as cleanly as I can, some glitter. Try not to get this mixture on everything on my table. Oh, sprinkle a little bit of glitter in there. So as if this wasn't completely messy enough, I add some glitter. I just kind of squish it through. So now it's sparkly. Okay, I've got my fingers here. Ooh, this is tricky. There we go. Okay, so now I have made a giant mess. I'm gonna go wash my hands before I build my snowman because I kind of want slightly cleaner hands just for my sake. So when I come back, we'll build our snowman, okay? So I'm back, I'm clean, I'm ready to build my snowman. While I was washing my hands, the mix kind of set a little bit. So it's a little drier now. So when you pick it up and mold it into your snowman, your hands aren't going to get quite as messy as they did before. So I'm ready to build my snowman. I have my friend Olaf with me to help me. So let's get started. So first, what you need to know is that a snowman has three parts to its body. So it's got three balls that build it up, but the bottom one is the biggest one. So I mean, you can see on Olaf, he's got this big part over here and then this part over here, and then his head is kind of not really a circle, not a ball, but you know, Olaf is special. So I'm gonna start by making the biggest ball. So I'm gonna take a bunch. Now see, when I touch it and then I pick up my fingers, it's not the mess it was before. Take a bunch, squish it together, and it packs really nicely. I'm gonna add a little bit more to this one because I want it to be the bottom one. So I'm gonna add some. Do you wanna build a snowman? There we go. Or ride our bike around the halls? I think so. There's the bottom. I'm gonna kind of push the rest of the snow over so that he's got a place to sit. Hang in there, Joan. Okay, so now I do the second one. The second one is still big, but not quite as big as this bottom one. Medium size. So again, pack it together. you try and roll it out, it's probably going to crumble underneath your hands. So you're going to kind of want to rotate it in your hands and squish together. And add a little bit more. Okay. Like this size. Push really carefully on the top here so that this part sits. If you push it too hard, it's going to crumble underneath you. So now for his head. His head is again another round ball, but it's going to be tiny. It's not going to be shaped like Olaf, because I don't think that shape will sit well on my snowman. So there's mine. Again, just a little pat here. And there's my snowman. 1, 2, 3. Now, if you want, you can decorate your snowman. That would mean he would need 2 arms. So you can go outside and get some sticks, little twigs maybe, and stick them in here for his arms. You can even get some really, really little sticks. And if you want to build, if you want to make Olaf, he's got some sticks for his hair. If you have beads at home, different color beads that you can string onto a necklace, then you can use some black beads for his eyes and his buttons. You can even use black beans. So if you have black beans at home, you can use that. They don't actually even have to be black. You can do whatever color you want. You can give Olaf some beautiful blue eyes. And then for his nose, which is orange, I mean, he's got a carrot, but if we try and stick a carrot in here, it's going to crumble and it's going to be way too big. So I suggest, you know, just rolling up a little piece of construction paper or even draw one on paper and kind of stick it in there. But that's your snowman. I hope you enjoyed making it. What you can do now, if you really liked the Frozen ride, is you can go on lots of other rides at Disney by clicking on my virtual trip to Disney World that's also attached to this post, and just read through the first 2 slides to know how to do it. And then you'll be able to go all over Disney World and ride all the rides that you want to ride and even see some shows. And maybe even get a little bonus treat in there from Miss Jillian. But it's a fun way to enjoy Disney while we can't really go down there this summer in a safe way. So enjoy your trips and all the other trips that you take today with your teachers, and have a great day. Bye, guys.